This is H.G. Bailey, and welcome back to Let's Play Mystic Arc! Since last time, I made my way back to Keepinsign to rest up and sell some excess items, and now we got the hydro area to go to, see if we can't find that arc. We could have tried going there earlier, but our open card wouldn't have worked before upgrading it after defeating the Death Knights there. So we would have been locked out eventually. Now, coming up here, oh, one thing I wanted to mention, with Mirianne, the reason I'm using her is because she's almost at level 18, and she's going to learn a really, really good spell coming up here. So first things first, let's get the door open. Well, the right digit has to be a 9, so that leaves 2. Now, let's see, coming up here, we have item synthesis. Kind of like what we had before with the jar there, back in Children's World. The way it works is that there's 5 different kinds of items. Solid, liquid, magical, mineral, and vegetable. The key items, not vegetables. Well, let's see what we got here. And you gotta, for the item synthesis, you gotta combine the items in different ways in order to synthesize new items. Usually, the really good stuff, though, requires a key item in order to make. Okay, so let's see what we got here. Let's hope this works. Haha! Now, I didn't figure out the recipes on my own. Nitrodon was skilled enough to find the recipes for me, so thanks a lot. Not to mention which items are considered liquid or solid or magical or whatever. And yeah, we got a little strange inn here. We can't save here, at least not to my knowledge. So you can get your MP restored here and all that, but that's all. But you'll still be hungry. Okay, so let's get to some item synthesis over here. See how that works. Okay. What? This is all going automatically, by the way, viewers, so I don't know what the point of that was, but okay. Alright, so this is the item synthesis machine, and to get the good stuff, we need a key item to use as a base material, so we can get rid of all these old key items that we've been holding on to for so long. It lets you clear some inventory space, too, so that's pretty nice. So let's start with Beach Sap here. You could use spare ribs or the scrap of paper as a base material. Either or will do. And then we need a liquid. Any liquid item will do. A potion, antidote, whatever. And yeah, we get a pretty good shield there. So let's equip that. It's pretty good for the main character there. Now, for now, there's only a couple things that we can make out of this. So let's go with black iron. You could also use the bottle of candies or false tooth for the base material. And then mix that with a magical item. And we get a machine gun. That's actually just a piece of body armor there for Lux. So let's get that to you. How much more powerful is that for you? Oh, wow. Pretty powerful compared to what we had before. Awesome. And let's see. There's one more guaranteed recipe that we can do at this point. Let's see. Let's go with the deck brush. Well, let me see what else happens here. Let's go liquid. And then we need a solid type item. So let's go with the spare mask we just found that I'll never use. And what did it come back as? Where is it? It's the same thing as before. No, it isn't, actually. When you use that particular combination of recipes, you get the deck brush back, except now it's an equipable weapon. So, yeah, that's pretty nice for Maesia there. Now, we do have some random recipe, so I'm going to make a backup save state here, just in case I don't get quite what I want out of this. So, with the equipment that you get out of the machine, even though there are multiple recipes for the same piece of equipment, if you redo that recipe, you won't be able to get another one of that piece of equipment. You can only have one in your inventory at a time. So if you get a recipe that would have otherwise done the same thing, well, you get a mana bottle would be the most common thing you can get out of it. Let's see what else we can do. See, Battle of Candies with a magical item. That's the same thing as the Full Metal Jacket recipe. Yeah, mana bottles are nice, but that's not quite what I'm looking for here. Well, let's see what else we got. Okay, let's see. False Tooth with a magical item. Can I get something else other than mana bottles? Well, the other items you can get are an HP seed, an MP seed, and what else is there? An intelligence seed. And I would like to get at least one or two intelligence seeds out of this, which I'm not gonna, but I'll just reload my save file or something and try again. Usually I'm not this profoundly unlucky. Wow. Yeah, that didn't work out at all, so... Okay, well, I'll just keep on trying again until I... Yeah, just reload and try to mess with the RNG to get more of what I actually want out of this. Haha! There we go! Alright, well, that's one intelligence seed. Maybe I can get another one out of the rest of these that I've got. Okay, we're back. And one other thing I decided to do was I went back to the beach woods to get some more beach sap with an empty bottle so that way I can get another shot at getting an intelligence seed. Though, since I already got one, I don't think it's necessary to go overboard with it. We'll see what we can do, though. And nuts. I don't really care about those mana bottles, but... Okay, well, that's the best we could do. We got an intelligence seed, and I used it on Kaimawu there, so yeah, look at that magic stat. Pretty good, pretty good. If you want to go nuts using save states to manipulate the RNG to get more intelligence seeds for Kaimawu, that would be a really, really good idea. But I'm not gonna. They're pretty hard to get. And let's see, we got a level for Mirian. Oh, I can't see her spells. Well, we got a level for her, and she learned Hurricane. That's 120 damage all enemies. It is obscenely efficient. And it's also a nature spell, so it'll work on those tetugens we got coming up instead of, like, the fire or the ice spells. So it's basically slightly weaker than the Holy Emblem spell, except... what was it? Oh yeah, it costs a lot less. So, that's pretty nice. Now, what do we got here? Oh. Yeah, I kind of noticed. I wonder why they shut down the whole thing, though. Oh. I thought he was like some legendary hero. Well, evidently... Man, that must have been a really long time ago. What do you mean? What plan? Ah. Okay, well, I guess we're in the right place. Well, so what happened to everyone here? Oh, so they built the whole thing? But then, how come they don't know anything about this? They, like, have their memory wiped out or something? Oh, yeah, that's the same thing as before. Okay, well, now we need to actually get into the Hydra area. Oh, I should, like, sort my inventory or something. That's better. Let's try that one again. Can I get in there? The card is supposed to work, isn't it? What do you mean, go up to keep in sign? That doesn't make sense. Well, if we go up here, it's all black and white. What's going on? Well, just like before, I suppose, but is there anything in here? I don't think there is. So how do we end up in keeping sign, then? Well, we're back out here, but yeah, you can't get back. So yeah, let's just go back to where we were and check out the Hydra cell. Alright, let's take a look around. Let's see, first things first, I think I want to go to the right, yeah. Let's go to the far right here. They got these tiles here. I would think there's supposed to be some kind of conveyor belt, but it's not working. I heard someone speculate that maybe it was because of the translation patch. Maybe there was like a bug with it or something. But it works that way in the original Japanese version too. So yeah, I don't know what's going on. But all right, we got a new enemy, Tetsujin. Stronger version of the ones we've met up with previously. Now, since there are so many of these guys, I don't want to waste my time with using, like, kill spells. I'm just going to go for the brute force method with Hurricane. Yeah, hit all four of them. Nice. Yeah, look at that damage. Okay, I want to turn one of those Tetsujins into a figurine. Yeah, they can also use that on you. That could be a problem. If I need to, I will heal. Well, let's at least kill that guy. Ow! Quit it. I'm worried if I attack that I might die if I don't kill the one. That's... Yeah. Oh, okay, I'm not dead. I meant to do that. Well, let's see if I can finish that guy off, then. Aw, come on! I don't want to use Hurricane. That would probably kill both of them, but maybe an Ice Rock Nail might just finish the guy off. Of course, that would depend on me actually hitting the guy. Okay, never mind, then. Well, I might as well save that one to... What is it? To turn into a figurine. But I still gotta kill the other one. Now, if it was only just, like, those two guys, I'd probably use Alluring Eyes to reduce their magic and then cast Kill on them. No, I don't want to do that. Let's go Alluring Eyes. Maybe I can still do that with this guy. Because, yeah, Kamawu, not going to be dealing a whole lot of damage to these guys. Oh, boy. This could hurt. Yep, that's gonna hurt. Ow! Well, this isn't going as planned. Let's see what we can do. I've gotta kill that one on the right there. Somehow. See, I'm pretty sure I can kill that guy now without dying from a counterattack. Okay, we're good. Okay, what do we got other than that, though? Okay, we don't really have much else. Okay, well then let's try and reduce its attack power so that when it runs out of MP, it won't be able to hurt us. Of course, if he just keeps on spamming Plasma Field over and over again, that could be a problem. Yeah, let's try reducing your magic stat. Or we could just totally whip the guy. Why not? Okay, let's see. We already got that done. And I can't really debuff any more of its stats that I would care about. Let's see, if I can drain its MP with Kiss of Death, then it might actually run out of MP. It doesn't have that much. I think it only has like 60 MP or something. So, yeah, we're getting there. Okay, now let's actually try turning it into a figurine there. Oh, I should probably be using Power Wave every now and then when I'm at like full HP. Maybe I can reduce its magic stat curse, though. Can anyone else get a turn? No. But yeah, if I reduce its magic stat, it won't be able to hit me with Plasma Field if it actually has the MP to do that. Which, it's not gonna in a moment. Okay, now we're basically invulnerable here against this guy. Okay, I'll give it one more try, and if that doesn't work, then I'll just skip to when I actually get the damn thing to work. Okay, one time, dealer. Aw, man. Okay. Haha! Finally got it! Whew! Wow, that took a lot of tries, but that is the last figurine that I want to make in the game. The rest of the worlds, yeah, they don't have anything that I would really care about. But alright, so let's see, we got the treasure on this floor. Let's head on down. There is another staircase in the upper left of that floor that would take us up here. Or not there. It would take us to the upper left of this floor. But I just think it's faster to go this route because the other staircase on the previous floor takes a while to get to. The stairs over here are the ones that actually take us to the end, not the previous floor. Okay, we're on the final floor here. By the way, after previous battles, let's see, Tokyo, learn Death Guard, and that'll be really useful in the next world because there's a random enemy there who can also use the kill spell. And let's see, Maesia, she learned Full Health, which restores a single character to, well, full health. So, unlike the High Health spell, which is only 180 MP. Now, let's see, we got four rooms that we can go to from here. The upper left room there doesn't have anything in it, so don't worry about that one. The two lower rooms have some treasure that I'd like to get while we're here. Not that I'll actually use it, it's just, but it's the principle of the thing. I wonder if, you know, the reason the conveyor belts aren't working is because the power is off here. I never thought about that before. Kind of reminds me of the wrecked ship, or whatever it was called in Super Metroid. Okay, well, just, oh, I didn't check out the sign. Yeah, I better check out the sign just to show you what we got here. So, yeah, there it is. We gotta go this way in order to get the fire arc. By the way, as far as using the Power Wave ability for Felice there, remember, it deals, its attack power is equal to your current HP. So, if you're going to use it, compare it to what you'd get out of your regular weapon. So, let's see, we got 103, 50, and then 40 from the light arc, so 193 attack power. So, if your HP is below 193, you don't want to use Power Wave. Just go with a regular attack there. But for getting through this area, we finally get some energy released. Hey, we get colors back. Would have made more sense if they showed the sound coming back when, what is it? Yeah, when we get to the second part of the world with Dupro there and all that. Well, you can't hear anything changing, but, well, just trust me, it is changing. Hey, people are getting their age back. Or young age, I suppose. Hey, all right. Okay, well, this is... Now that we're done here, unfortunately, we cannot use the crystal to get out of here. So, let's see. Where do I want to go? I want to go to Keep Inside. Basically, at every town, all the people are saying, hey, I'm young again, or we got sound back, or whatever. Or, we got color back now. Thanks for helping us out, or whatever. But there is still one more thing I want to do here. Oh, by the way, if you gave the beach sap and black iron to the blacksmith back at Ratwood there, he'll have it ready for you now. But I decided not to go for that. I just figured we're going to get a better weapon soon enough anyway. But what does the fire arc do for us anyway? Find out next time on Let's Play Mystic Arc. This is H.G. Bailey, signing off. Have a good day!